Hello everybody and welcome in this video in which I'm going to give you one short tip, performance suggestion, idea, whatever you want to call it, on the C major fugue, J.S. Bach, obviously book one of the well-tempered clavier, so the well-tempered clavier. So I've dived into this a little bit more in the masterclass live, which goes every two Sunday, and this masterclass has already been recorded. I've combined that with the recording of this piece, so it's already recorded. I will link it here in the video in case you would like to check it out. So in these very short videos, just one tip, very short, and this is about the tempo of the piece. And you know, tempo, you can talk about tempo in a very absolute way, taking a metronome number. I know we've been talking on metronomes a lot lately on the channel, but that's a different thing. Those metronome numbers given by Czerny and by others are, of course, indication of how they play it. It doesn't mean that we have to play it exactly like that. More important, actually, is the range that it opens. I'm not saying that you should take Czerny as a source to play Bach, but it is an interesting person to dive into, because his speed indications are really interesting and inspired me in doing this fugue differently than I actually recorded it a few years ago. So the main thing actually to decide when you play a piece of Bach, actually from Bach to Beethoven, because for Beethoven, Mozart, Haydn, it applies the same, and in fact you could continue a little bit more. The main thing is to decide in which note value you're going to play the piece in. If it's really in quarter notes, or in half notes, in eight notes, maybe in 16th notes. And you know what? That the time signature is not always, if ever, indicating that very clearly. You have to figure that out by looking to the notation, the density of the notes, of the harmonies, and the note values. So if you have, for instance, in common time, note values that go beyond 16th notes, then you are in a kind of slowing down phase of that common time. Let's say that the tempo ordinario is 60, very roughly said, for the common time, then you go a little bit slower. If the harmony also is densed more than usual, meaning not accentuating or helping, or just have been built on the foundation of the strong beats on 1 and 3, but actually adding harmonies in between, and maybe even per 8th note, then you're slowing down the basic tempo again. So that's really important to look at. And we're going to dive into this in the masterclass more in depth, and I've been talking on this actually very much on the channel. I will do it over and over again, because that's some basic element of understanding. Here in this fugue, I've recorded that way back 3 years ago in a clear 8 quarter note structure. So because looking at the piece, you see it kind of tempo ordinario, 16th notes, fastest notes value. Harmonies are a little bit on the edge, I admit. So I think I've chosen a tempo about quarter note 52. But I've struggled with some elements as well. Like for instance, the 32nd Nachschlag. This one. If you play it faster, it becomes very rhythmical and very dynamic. And actually the theme, as I feel it, is more cantabile. If you slow down the tempo, and come back to that in a second, to the cantabile effect much more. And if you continue then with the theme, so here, so playing this piece from within an 8-note structure is actually very logical. And then coming back to Czerny, I was checking the Czerny metronome indication, because I think it's very interesting to look at that. Those people lived in the edge of the 18th century, still had contact with Beethoven, and had contact with Neve. And Neve, I mean, that's a kind of chain of tradition that it's way too interesting not to look at that. And if you consider his time indication, his tempo indication metrically, which I believe even without a theory, as long as we are not able to play in a meaningful way, but even technically, all those metronome numbers that only Jenny left, I mean, what else are you going to do? You can disagree with the results, but it's either single or it's either double beat, but that's another discussion. If I look to that number metrically, I come in an 8-note tempo, and I was a little bit shocked when I saw that for the first time. But then playing it in that way opened my perspective for these elements that I was talking about. So this cantabile-like version, I believe it was Andy, called it on the channel in a comment, it's like a very old Froberger fugue, and maybe that's a perfect way to see it. Becomes very cantabile, very gentle, very nice to play actually as well. You should try it. And that's my one tip for this video. Hope you like that. If this is your first time here on Authentic Sound, I'd love to have you to join the Authentic Sound community by hitting the subscribe button, making videos from Bach to Beethoven performances, diving into the performance practice also, and sometimes turning things a little bit around, because I like to reconstruct some contextual things around the music, look at it from different perspectives, like in this video combining Czerny with Bach. But the notation drives me also very much, and the only meaning, the only goal that it serves is what every musician should drive, and is actually driving, actually musician is trying to find the emotions that are underneath the music, and being able to share that with you through this platform is really making me feel a privileged person. So thank you for considering subscribing to the channel. And if you do so, we see each other very soon again. Bye.